Friday night. 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite spoke with police today and joins us now with the new details. Catherine, why do they say the suspect knew her?
Well, Brad, there are two things here. For starters, there were no signs of forced entry into Carmen Sanders' apartment. And secondly, she was stabbed several times. Now, because that attack was done at close range and so violent, police believe this was personal and not random. They don't have a motive right now or any suspects in custody. Police are still interviewing several people, including Sanders' boyfriend, Terry Taylor. She lived with him. Taylor told police he was at work Friday night and came home to find Sanders on the bedroom floor, stabbed to death.
As with any case like this, we're not sure exactly who our suspect is right off hand. What we'll start with is we'll start on the inner circles, people closest to her in her normal everyday life, and that's the way that the boyfriend is being treated now. He's a witness to this. He's the one that found her. We're talking to him, getting information from him. At some point in time, he'll either be eliminated as a suspect or become one.
Police tell me they are still checking Taylor's alibi of being at work. In the meantime, they seized his truck and Sanders' car to look for evidence. Police told me that's standard procedure. Now, police also said they took Sanders' boyfriend in for questioning Friday night, but he hasn't been arrested, and we tried to talk to him today, and he wouldn't answer the door. Now, if you have any information about the murder of Carmen Sanders, call Crime Stoppers at 601-355-TIPS. You don't have to give your name, and you could get up to a $25 cash reward. Brad.